that we got a pair of wide receivers who certainly want to be targeted throughout the game. It's the Lions going up against the Jets. With that, let's welcome in our fine broadcast team. Here are Brandon Godden and Charles Meeks.
Here's the punter, Sam Martin, now ready to get it started. Get strapped in. It's just about time to get the party started. That's fielded in the end zone. Oh, look at that. A second spin. Turning and turning and turning. And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. So now here comes the Jet offense as they get ready to take over. They'll be led out by a guy who only became a starter relatively late in his career. It's the well-traveled veteran, Josh McCown.
Josh McCown comes from a family of quarterbacks. Three have started in college, and two have started games in the NFL.
McCown now on first down. Look, he's going to take a shot right away. And that's caught inside the 35. A big gain there on the first play of the game. 45 yards. Well, we know he's got the speed there. He needed the speed and the hands. A great catch.
And because of that speed, you have to respect it as a defender. So you have to even play like and make sure you're somehow in contact with it. And he's able to do exactly what you said. Use the speed to his advantage and go up and get the football. That's a big-time play right there.
This team is not going to make it easy for you.
That physical group, we just saw it there on that play. He came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Kerry Hyder able to drop him for a loss of four. With Charles Davis, Brandon Godden with you. And the dreaded third and long here for the offense. From the gun, it's McCown. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 15. 23 yards on the play.
In recent years, the slot receivers really gained stature in the NFL because they could do so many things. Yes, they can have that wide left, your normal wide receiver, and have that kind of courage and toughness to run routes in the middle of the field and become dependable targets for their quarterbacks and move the sticks. Those guys are worth their weight in gold.
McCown going to hustle his guys to the line. On second down, 4-10. Oh, and up, fighting his way in for a Jets touchdown. Matt Forte, a 10-yard touchdown run. And the Jets take the ball down the field and score on their opening drive.
And that touchdown gives them a touchdown lead before they attempt the extra point. What a great way to end the half.
Yeah, great job to put themselves in front. And now, see on the sideline, special teams defense scrambling, saying we want to preserve this for the final moments of this second quarter. Captain Zero out now as he'll kick this one away. On the return, Dwayne Washington. That's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. As it will come with 15 seconds to play in the first half. To throw on second down to Stafford. He goes underneath to Abdullah. And Abdullah lost the football. And it's scooped up by the Jets. And they'll start with great field position at the 41-yard line. And when he was in Nebraska, Abdullah was known to have some fumble issues.
I remember it well coming out of the draft. Big topic of conversation. Could that be cured? You know, why did he have the type of fumbles he had? It continued.
Oh, man, it's caught. Touchdown, Jets. Robbie Anderson, as time expires in the first half. just before the half ends, the prayer is answered defensively. A disaster there.
I know often we're surprised when this actually works. I mean, the excitement level goes way up, but maybe we shouldn't be, because I know as a defender, you got to play the ball in this situation, but you can't interfere with the receiver, because remember, it's a spot foul, and it'd be first and goal if it happens in the end zone, and you don't want to give up that play. That little bit of hesitancy often works really well for offensive guys.
And it's good to make it 14-0. So we've hit half, and hello, I guess Larry's halftime show is button through, and we are moving on and ready to go for the third quarter. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. This is taking just shy of the 10 here, and he's going to be run over, hit hard, as he'll be marked down. Lions offense now with a football first here to begin quarter number three. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments they made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
But
this is a
new thing.
I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. On first down, Abdullah. And he is going to feel that one. Knocked down hard right at the line of scrimmage. Credited with a one-yard gain there to make it second and nine.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
Back now here on EA Sports. It's the Lions trailing, but with possession of the football as we get set to bring you the fourth quarter. Here's Stafford now, second down. Looking right sideline, but it's incomplete. Jared Aberderis, the intended receiver. And it's third down.
Had the right idea there, trying to throw it to the sideline, but he let it just a little bit too much, trying to get it out to his receiver. That's a call to the ground, that's brilliant.
Here's Stafford. That's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. Well, they haven't had a whole lot of success in the passing game here. Now, in the second half, he's thinking, I guess maybe just take a shot deep.
I think you're right. Almost looking for a bailout, isn't he? Let my receiver go up and make a big play for me. Can I give you a penalty downfield? Maybe pick up an interference call and get that yardage downfield. Anything trying to get going again, but you're right. He definitely took a shot.
So with that, we can just about close the book on this one, Charles.
Yeah, what's the old expression about slim and none? The slim just left out of them.
Now they're down to none.
Yes, exactly right.
And off his back foot, he'll heave this one deep. And this will be caught. In the end zone, touchdown, Jets. Robbie Anderson, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Jets find a way to stretch their lead. They were still throwing with a comfortable lead here late, and now that lead even more comfortable.
And your first thought is it bad luck? They went into this one ahead of time, that maybe they're seeking some revenge, or they just don't like them. But the other thing that always hits me is, are they worried about playoff positioning? Right? Are they worried about, do you need enough points in case there's a tiebreaker that comes into play later?
One after now from Catanzaro. And it is now 21-0. Catanzaro out now as he'll kick this one away. This is fielded at the chalk of the 10. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. Detroit offense now as they head back out onto the field. Let's just be frank. They're playing for pride at this point.
That's all that's left because victory, not a chance now. And I can't wait to see how they actually go about doing it because there are a lot of people watching the body language of the guys on the field now. And if they call plays they want executed, they need to do that and do it really well. Otherwise, there could be repercussions.
We'll see how they handle the waiting moments of this one. And that one drops to the ground. Incomplete. Clock stops here. Just inside of 20 seconds. 19 left. Well, too much over. Too much mustard there on that pass.
They really turned it loose, didn't they? Really cut loose with that one. Sharp, strong. Didn't lead to a completion. That's very difficult.
Now it's Stanford. And that is incomplete. 16 seconds now on the clock.
I'm not sure if we can spot any tendency here on this third down. They could have run it or passed it. Either one was available. They chose to try and get it through the air, but they were unsuccessful.
Desperation time for Stafford on fourth down. And it'll be incomplete with 11 seconds remaining now. They had to go through with such little time remaining. And that'll be just about all she wrote for this one. So they tried to go for it for pride, but it really wouldn't matter. This game is already determined.
No doubt about it. This one was over a while ago.
Trying to lay one up deep. And that is caught. But the bank judge right there to say incomplete. And it's incomplete. Clock now showing 0-0-5. That's all we have left here in the fourth.
Here we go.
Fourth quarter, you got the big lead. If you're coaching Charlie, you still taking shots like that downfield? And the Lions, pressure too strong. Down he goes. The storyline of this one, Charles, no doubt, the number zero. Zilch, nada. A shutout so hard to do in the NFL.
It really is. What an accomplishment, because you feel that not just on the defensive side, but as a whole team.